Mr. Sweetface has a kid to camera. Really? Hey YouTube, what's up? It's Tori Lee and welcome back to my channel. Today I am doing a 5-month update of my son. This is Junior. He's so big. Junior enjoys hanging out with his big sister and watching cartoons. He is very independent. Since about 3 months, he likes to be sitting up. So throughout this video, I'll show you guys different stuff that we use because he does not like to be laying down on his back. He does really well with tummy time, but he prefers to be upright and all in the business, huh? So yeah, he's not very fussy. He is sleeping through the night. He is a very good baby. I really just wanted to talk to you guys about some of the must-have baby items that I purchased during my pregnancy and got for my baby shower. I know I did a what's in my diaper bag and a baby gear haul. So I just wanted to highlight some of the daily items that we use outside of like the stroller, the bassinet, the big ones, but on a day-to-day ones that have really made a big difference with him. I hope you guys enjoy and we will get right to the video. One of the first things I want to talk about that has been super helpful is the nose Frida. Now, when you go to the hospital or in a lot of like baby care kits, they'll have like the little ball syringe squeezy thing to get the snot out of your baby's nose when they're congested. But my fiance actually picked this up, and this is the little tube part that you put like right the baby's nostril, and you actually suck the snot out through this end. Now it sounds super gross and really weird, but there, if you open it, I just cleaned it, so that's what fell out. It wasn't snot, I promise. There's actually like a little filter here, so none of the snot is actually gonna come up through the tube and into your mouth, if that makes sense. And it also came with this saline nose spray. It looks like this, and then if you just pop it off, it just sprays, I don't know if you guys can see that, just straight up into the air. And this is super helpful because this gets the job done. This is a lot better than any little bulb syringe I've ever used. And I actually didn't get this until Junior was about 2 months old. And he was the most congested like the first month that we brought him home. This is a really good product and I wish I would have known about this with my daughter. So definitely you want to invest in the nose Frida for sure. The next item I want to talk about is the Dock-A-Tot. Now, in my other video, I did mention that this was a little bit of an investment. I believe it is about $170. The Dock-A-Tot has been a lifesaver for us just because Junior didn't like the bassinet at first. I like it because I can bring it from the bedroom down to the living room, down to if, you know, we're going to my mom's house for a little bit. It's just really easy to pick up and move. When I was doing research, they talk about when the baby first comes home, they want to feel like that swaddled feeling, like they want to feel close and comforted. So when you put the baby into the Dock-A-Tot, it has those walls and it kind of just makes everything like really cozy and makes them feel really comfortable. And that was the only way he would sleep for the first month or so. And we're still using it today. So that was definitely worth the investment. In addition to that, I wanted to talk about the Mamaroo. Now in my baby gear haul video, I actually mentioned that we were gonna get the Nuna Leaf. I ended up getting the Mamaroo. Junior did not like it like the first month and it was a pretty big investment. So I was a little weary about it. I'm like, oh my gosh, like this is really expensive. We could have just got him a regular seat. But now he loves it. I would say that that is definitely worth it. I have heard it's a hit or miss with your kids, but I wouldn't say to give up on it if your baby doesn't like it at first, because Junior definitely didn't like it at the beginning, but now he's grown into it and I definitely rely on it a lot. The next thing I want to talk about is the Sit Me Up floor seat, and we got the frog one. Junior wants to be upright and see what's going on. And with this seat, I think they say not to put them up in it until they're like 3 months and they're able to support their neck. So that's what we did. But since he's been able to hold up his head, he loves it because he can sit on the floor with his sister. She plays toys next to him. But we really enjoyed that. And I definitely think that one is a necessity also. Leading into that, I want to mention the Boppy pillow. I also showed you guys that on my baby haul, my baby gear haul. The Bobbi pillow can be used in a lot of different ways. When we first brought Junior home, I used it a lot to help me with nursing, and we also did tummy time on it. And then now, since he's able to sit up a little bit, we'll sometimes put it on the bed and sit him in it so that he can sit upright. So it has a lot of different functions. It is definitely something that all mommies need for their babies. Another product that is a must-have is the Infinito 4-in-1 carrier. Now, you don't have to get this exact brand. I like this one just because you can switch the different positions. You can do a rear-facing setting, a front-facing setting, and they can go on your back, and it kind of adjusts depending on how big they are. But I would not be able to get a lot of things done without that. And I relied on it a lot, like the first 2 to 3 months, because he always wanted to be with me. I couldn't really set him down and have him chill, like while I was doing laundry or anything like that, or dishes. So having that carrier has really helped me be able to get like household stuff done and still attend to him at the same time. And what I've noticed is when I'm using it, he ends up falling asleep in it. If you have a fussy baby that just wants to be on you all the time and you've got other stuff that you've got to do around the house, I would suggest putting them in that and seeing if that helps them fall asleep, because it definitely has helped me. Next item is kind of random, but it has been super helpful for me, and it's the Boon Lawn drying rack. Now, I know they have a lot of different options for drying racks for baby supplies, but I have used a couple in the past, and this one has worked perfectly. I like how all the water just drains in the bottom, and then once everything's dry, I can just dump the pan out. It keeps everything nice and organized and sanitized, and I really enjoy it. So this is another must-haves on my baby gear list. Another piece of gear that I want to mention that I deem as essential is the Angel Care baby bath support. Now, I at first got Junior another one that kind of almost was like a hammock style, but what I noticed was that it didn't support him well, and he would always like slide down. So then I switched to the Angel Care bath support, and it has been amazing. I haven't had any issues with it, and it really just holds him in place, if that makes sense. Like, he's not sliding all over. His butt fits perfectly right at the bottom, and he's still able to like kick his feet, and he's upright a little more, which I mentioned that he likes to be upright. And it's not super big, so if I bathe him and my daughter together, there's still plenty of room for her to play too. And last but not least, I wanted to mention the Wubba Nub elephant pacifier. My son is obsessed with this pacifier, and it's really genius if you think about it. It's the pacifier, and then it's got the animal attachment. And I think there's a lot of different animal options. For my son, I've done like a lot of elephant theme. That's just kind of our thing. And it is awesome. I bought like a lot of like plush, like little like babies for him. And he doesn't even need any of those, because when he has his pacifier, it like sits like perfectly like on his chest, and he'll just hold on to it. And it's a good comfort mechanism. And it's also good because it doesn't get lost, because it has the animal attached to it. It can obviously get lost, but I feel like I lose like single pacifiers so much easier than this pacifier that has a little stuffed animal attached to it. And I really wish that I would have used this for my daughter, because I think it really would have helped. But this is definitely a necessity. If I go anywhere without it, then we are in big trouble. Okay guys, well, that pretty much sums up all of my must-have baby gear products. Hopefully I'm not missing anything. If you guys have any suggestions, or you want to let me know what one of your most needed items were, feel free to leave them in the comments. Hopefully it helps somebody out there. I know that especially as new moms, we get overwhelmed with buying a whole lot of unnecessary things. So I really just wanted to put this video out there to help somebody get more of like a clear guide of what are some non-essential items that you're gonna use every day, if that makes sense. I guess it doesn't make sense, because if you're using it every day, it is essential, but I mean just outside of like clothing, wipes, diapers, that type of thing. These are products that if I don't use every day, it's every other day. So again, I really hope this helps you guys, and I hope you guys enjoyed, and we will see you next time. Bye.